Here he is leaving Mar-a-Lago.
There he is!
His supporters frothing.
He's trusting in God for the outcome.
I just hope to see him run for 2024 and become the president again.
3 hours later, Trump touched down in New York, his motorcade snaking its way to Trump Tower, where Donald will most likely spend the night chugging Diet Cokes and focusing on his upcoming arrest, potential mugshot, and appearance at the Lower Manhattan Court.
I will forever support this beautiful man. God bless President Trump, best president this country ever had. I'm proud to say I'm gay, and I love this man.
Trump is facing a reckoning over an alleged $130,000 hush money payment made to porn star Stormy Daniels, who says she had a 2006 liaison with the former president.
He was just another male, and I was in a little skimpy outfit and have huge boobs.
While the payment itself isn't illegal, falsifying it as legal fees is. And that's exactly what Trump's then-lawyer, Michael Cohen, is accused of doing in 2016 during Trump's election campaign.
I should not be held accountable for Donald Trump's dirty deeds.
The two dozen charges are yet to be revealed, but some are potential felonies which carry jail terms. His team and supporters are livid.
It's just an extenuation of a continued attack on President Trump, on nothing. Nothing burgers.
This is something that we believe is a political persecution, and he's gearing up for a battle.
New York City officials gearing up for total chaos.
Our message is clear and simple. Control yourselves.
Police tell us there are no specific or credible threats, but they are prepared for violence.
Trump gearing up to walk into court 6 hours from now to plead not guilty.
And when life gives Trump lemons, we go to Steve Clemons. Steve, good to see you. Paint a picture for us of the situation right now. How tense is it over there?
Well, it's tense because we're all waiting to see what the underlying counts are. We know that he's in New York. He's going to he has 34 counts. We know probably falsifying business records with an underlying serious crime that the New York DA thinks is worth bringing all these charges. So, yeah, things are tense. We're waiting for him to show up in court and go through the process of essentially being arrested, if you will, for the first time in American history for a former U.S. president.
Can we expect to see a real mugshot of Trump plastered everywhere online, or are we going to have to settle for an AI one like this?
Well, I think we've all talked before about what Donald Trump did with NFTs. And so, you remember the big laser shooting out of his eyes? I don't know. There's going to be no mugshot. You know, in this indictment, they decided they're not going to handcuff him. They're not going to make him sit in a prison cell. And they're not going to take a mugshot. So, yeah, I think it'll be AI, or, you know, maybe President Trump will make his own NFT later for sale.
Well, it's probably wise they don't do that, right, because of the, what would you call it, propaganda value of those images for the Trump campaign. He thinks he's raised $7 million since being indicted. I don't know if that's true, but it's certainly believable. Is it possible that this whole episode will actually ignite his or revive his political career?
Well, Ali, there's no doubt that it has. I mean, I think right now, if you just think back a few months ago, Fox News, you know, which used to be his biggest support base, was trying to peel itself away from him. And he was kind of fading from the news as we saw, you know, other contenders come up. But since this has happened, since the raid, you know, remember over the classified documents, all of those issues that have come up to challenge President Trump legally have made him enormously popular. And he's raising a ton of money right now.
Trump has already planned an event in Mar-a-Lago after his return from Manhattan. What do you think he's going to say?
I think he's going to remind people of what he did in The Apprentice, and he's going to say, let's fire Alvin Bragg. You know, I think that he's, you know, come out and going to say that he's a victim again. The system is stacked against him. New York is politicized. And take back America, people, and that's what he's going to do. And he's going to say he's the best chance to take back the country and make it a great again.
That was very convincing, Steve. Are you a speechwriter? No comment. No,
okay, hey, Steve Clemons, thank you so much for your time tonight. Appreciate it.
Good to see you.